9 times out of 10 we're now cutting from computer files as opposed to tape. We still do cut from tape now and again, but the days of playing and playing and playing old analog masters are coming to an end just because the tapes are getting worn out. This has been mastered, it's ready to go. It's a Tina Marie thing, we're going to cut this as a 12 inch. So I've got a blank disc on the lathe here. This is a bit like a vinyl record. It's an aluminium disc, as we mentioned earlier. It's got some nitrocellulose on it. It's like semi-dry paint, so it's very soft. And on this here, this is the cutter head. There's a stylus that's heated, so that drops straight into the disc because it's very soft, and it just melts it away. And then what we do is we literally play the music in real time. It goes through some amplifiers in this rack over here. We basically blasted about 500 watts per channel into some little coils, like a headphone coils in here, which are attached to the stylus that record the disc. And those vibrations, the music you hear from the speakers, the sound waves, are recorded as wavy grooves here on the record. When you play it back, you put your stylus in the groove, it vibrates, you amplify those vibrations, and that's your music. And that's it. You know, don't think this is high tech. You know, the basic idea of a flat disc with a groove in it goes back to 1887. So, you know, it's proper 19th century process, really. Let's drop that down there, that's ready to go. And we'll hit start. That will go across. This is a slightly larger disc than normal. It's a 14 inch disc. So that's just doing the run-in groove now. If you look over here, these are the amplifiers that are actually cutting the record. Just as I say that, go to a quiet bit. But if you watch here, that's the current that the cutter head is drawing. When the tambourine comes in, that will suddenly go up. You can see here there's a hi-hat going off here. So each hit of the hi-hat is just drawing more current. There you go. As a rule of thumb, the higher the frequency, the more current the cutter head needs to draw to make the coils move to cut those high frequencies. What also happens is there's a groove spacing computer in the lathe, so, and it gets a half revolution warning of what's coming up. So if you think of the record as a spiral from the outside going in, if you get a sudden bit of bass, the groove is going to move a long way laterally. So especially if you've got a long side, I mean this is easy, it's a 12 inch single, plenty of room, no problem. But if you've got a long album side, you're trying to get the groove as tight as you can to each other to get it all on. And if you get a sudden loud bit of bass, the bass could crash into the previous groove and that would cause a jump on the playback. So you need to use the computer in the lathe, which thinks, well, I've just cut this shape, I'm about to cut a groove like this, and actually will open up accordingly, give itself some room in order to fit that big bit of bass on. And then when the bass is finished, it will close up again.